GPL, but he's great at poking things out and not necessarily targeted at Golden, but with Ziggs, Orianna, both of those out there, we expected triple AP bans against Golden, but this time around, it's actually Pasa. Triple AP bans coming out from the Kuala Lumpur Hunters.
All right, so taking away the Ziggs, the Orianna, and the Gragas, so a lot of initiation potential, a lot of burst damage from this champions from the mid lane for Pasa. So taking away three potentially his main, but Nidalee is going to get banned out as well, so we're not going to see that one from... I just got mixed up because everybody's in different orders here, but we're not going to see that one for the side of KLH. But that left open Annie and Fiddlesticks while we see KLH pick up and look to hover over that Fiddlesticks for most likely for the support role.
Right, and going with your support very early on not only locks in something that's very strong, you can go for probably a Fiddlesticks and Annie going to be top tier support picks, at least in this game. Yeah. But it also doesn't really reveal too much of your strategy. No. If you're going to go for a heavy poke composition, heavy engage, you can pick supports that won't really give that away early on. But if you look over towards Hong Kong Attitude, they're going to go with really heavy engage, a lot of strength in the top lane from Shyvana. It will be a jungle Jarv in the fourth for their second pick.
Yeah, that Shyvana pick has either been 100% ban or 100% pick. So it's just back and forth with the teams. Who wants to get it first? Who wants to just bring it to the top lane and show their dominance? But Red's Renekton had something to say about that to that Shyvana player from last game on that FM. So
right.
A good job coming out from Red there. So maybe KLH might have a pocket Renekton to throw in that. But they're hovering over an AD carry, which we haven't seen in a long time. MF, the Lucia was there, which is a little bit more viable, but they lock in Zac instantly, and Jae-yung actually going to lock in Lucian for the bot lane, so Lucian Fiddlesticks there, and Zac, someone we haven't seen in, at least in NA, for a couple months.
Right, he kind of made a comeback with the 3.14 patch. If you spec all the way 21 points into defense, your sustain just goes through the roof, and as a sustain monster, Zac is works really well with him, but haven't really seen too much of him on the 3.13 patch, kind of phased out there, a couple of nerfs to his Blobblitz, yeah. And just being really outclassed by top laners like Shyvana, Renekton, Olaf, all extremely strong as well. But coming back, maybe they just want a big sort of sustainy rock up there in the top lane to hold his own against one of the more dominant top laners starting to emerge, at least in 3.13 in Shyvana.
The thing is, though, with the nerfs that Zac took to the face was the Blobblitz can be stepped over really easily, and Shyvana with the burnout can get to those Blobblitz a lot quicker. Has the AoE damage to destroy him when he's in the passive, so we'll see how it plays out. But the side of Hong Kong Attitude, they pick up Annie and Caitlyn for the bot lane, which is a phenomenal answer. Ooh. To the Lucian Fiddlesticks lane. The range that Annie has, the range that Caitlyn has, and the poke that they can provide, just so strong. But with them hovering over Blitz on the side of KLH, we could potentially see a jungle Fiddlesticks.
I mean, that would mean...
Oh, Nunu too. Hello.
We're
not going to say anything just yet.
This is where predictions sort of phase off. This is where you put
Tristana
the cover...
Tristana and Nunu. Okay, so...
Okay. Hmm. This is where you put the towel over your crystal ball and you set it to the side and you're just like, all right, we'll see what these guys have coming our way as well. So theoretically, that would be still a support Fiddlesticks.
Jungle Nunu, I feel.
With a jungle Nunu. Okay, that makes a little bit more sense. All right, so we're happy. We're good to go. But that is going to be a mid lane Lucian then. That's something we saw very first out of, I believe it was Complexity that played that in NACL first. And then you saw it almost that same night in OGN as well. So a lot of mid Lucians out there, not something you see all that much. It's a little bit like the mid Ezreal, not quite as mobile, but it does still give you a lot of just lane bully potential and a nice free farm kind of lane in that respect. And with a Tristana late game, doesn't get much more late game than adding a Nunu buff to that.
Blood Boil. Oh,
you don't
yes.
see that all that much more, but it's starting to come back in the hinterland of Season 3.
Season 4?
I don't know, that's the end of season 3,
oh, I
into
don't know.
Season 4.
I'm going crazy, but it's going to be, looks like an Ezreal, actually, for the side of Hong Kong Attitude to respond to the mid lane Lucian. So we're going to see
right.
the double AD carry, quote-unquote, meta come in here for mid lane and the bot duo. So, I'm wondering, as they're switching everything up, it could be mid Tristana. That could be potentially AP Tristana for the mid lane, too.
Okay, I'm not going to go that crazy,
I would
Dan,
like to see AP. They're lacking it. They have the Fiddlesticks. They have some Zac damage. Even Nuno throws in a little bit of hint. The Snowballs, the Ice Blast, you all know,
right,
the Absolute
right.
Zero. But a DFG Tristana is something you don't want to mess with.
It could be AP Ezreal, too. So not ruling out the AP choices, but it's kind of interesting to see the anything you can do, we can do better kind of attitude out of Hong Kong Attitude. They're just like, hey, you want to put an AD carry mid? We can do that, too. And going with a much more standard AD mid in Ezreal, see how he stacks up against kind of the new guard of Lucian coming into that middle lane. And like you said, could be AP Tristana, as Jae Yoong hasn't switched that back over. Keep in mind, summoners aren't quite in their regularly aligned columns. So Jae Yoong is the AD carry, whereas Golden is the AP, but appears to be a few role swaps coming out here. We'll have to talk about those once we get loaded into the game.
Yeah, and the way this game is shaping out, I expect all-out aggression. I want just in-your-face aggression action going on. I want to see first bloods coming out of like 2 minutes. But still, the invade potential from both sides is pretty strong. The Dark Winds from Fiddlesticks is dangerous. The rocket jump resets early on could be just really bad for the side of HKA. So we'll see if there's defensive posturing from HKA or maybe some aggression coming out from them. They have any stun as well. They could go with the Yordle Snap Traps from Caitlyn or just Piltover Peacemaker for the flat damage. But either way, it looks like we're actually loaded in here. Quick little pause for us, and we're going to restart the game. And not restart the game, but resume the game. And everybody's going to walk out of the base, and it looks like we're good to go for game one of today. It's going to be Kuala Lumpur Hunters taking on Hong Kong Attitudes.
All right, so for Hong Kong Attitude, I'm expecting a little bit more of an aggressive invade like you were talking, like you were looking forward to. You got a five-man anti-stun and a lot of poke to get in there, check some bushes out there, as Pasa will be kind of leading the charge out for Hong Kong Attitude. XXF going to be, I guess, kind of the front line.
He went boots.
KLH, he did go boots.
And two wards.
Yeah, boots in the two wards, a much more supportive kind of Nunu build because you have so much sustain in the jungle. You don't really have to be worrying about you know, picking up the Hunter's Machete very early on. So now it's going to be Hong Kong Attitude starting to camp out at the red buff.
All right, so they're going to let Jarvan lead the way, throw the standard out, reveal that brush, get the nice, fabulous Draven ward actually in that brush there. And with Annie with that stun, they're just going to be fearless. There's pings coming out, but XXF had a chance to walk towards the red buff and drop a ward at the entrance of the Wraiths. So potentially could see a blue slash red steal attempt from XXF on that Nunu, as Nunu is known for his counter jungling potential.
All right, so to start the game out, minions just about to spawn here in about 10 seconds. It will be Pasa there in that middle lane. Now, already get to see a little bit of a rotation here as Wazlin's heading over to that blue buff. And so no counter jungling to start things off for Kuala Lumpur Hunters, but with two deep red wards there for Hong Kong Attitude, they're going to start things off. Fei and Wind down there looking to steal away the red.
Yeah, so potentially just could see reverse of the jungle here. Wind gets red, blue, and then XXF gets blue, red, and they'll be on their way to try to gank this one out. But Red Hot Rays is actually kind of hanging around that blue buff and looking to possibly go towards a mid 2v1 against this Ezreal with Tristana, or could just go up towards a red buff and try to help XXF out over there. But we see the red buff get handed over, and Wind will be going into that bot lane very soon.
Oh, Wazlin's walked right in between, perhaps, and N'God, and so could have taken a little bit of damage there, but it's going to be solo. For right now, it's going to be Fiddlesticks. Red Hot Rays looking to help out XXF.
Oh, already mid, though. There's going to be a gank attempt on a Jae Yoong. He's going to be forced to flash away. Flag and Drag comes in. He's going to get ignited in first blood to Pasa. But here comes XXF. Going to throw the snowball in. Going to get some auto attacks. Down. Dark Winds comes in. And it's going to be a flash forward from XXF chasing down Pasa. Ice Blast comes in. A few more auto attacks. Will take this kill down. Can he get it in? Looks like he can. XXF gets that one. But now AFAT is going to flash forward, get the auto attack, and pick up a blue buff. Can Red Hot Rays get out? It will be just a nice little agreement to walk and part ways, as that's going to be a 2-for-1 in favor of Hong Kong Attitude in a very aggressive early game.
Yeah, Fiddlesticks only level 1 meant that he didn't have fear in that engagement, and now Fei at level 3 double buffed, going to have another set of double buffs coming his way if he wants it in his own red and blues. So incredibly strong jungle presence there. Was a 1-for-1 trade overall, but then you did see kind of the first casualty of war being Ezreal to make it a 2-for-1 at the end of that. Huge minion wave pushing into the top lane, and it's Wazlin's kind of up here by himself. Red Hot Rays as a support. You notice a lot of early roaming and should expect to see a little bit more of that. But now we got the jungler just kind of tangling it up in the jungle themselves.
He's level 2. That's going to be a flag drag forward. And with those boots, he'll be able to run out of there. So AFAT actually asserting a lot of dominance and protecting that blue buff that he knows is still up. Down bot, we see Golden and Wind, which we haven't talked about too much. Just going to be that little island that top lane is definitely known for. But up top, we actually had a little bit of an exchange there, forcing out an exhaust from Red Hot Rays.
All right, so top lane's going to be a little bit pressured as Wazlins and Red Hot Rays got shoved under their turret for a couple of different waves, and with no jungle pressure anywhere near, should expect to see a very, very aggressive from the longest auto attack duo lane that you can possibly have in League of Legends. That Caitlyn, Annie, just a lot of trade potential there, especially very early on. Blue buff getting given over to Pasa. He's going to come back to lane with a Tear of the Goddess. As well as a Doran's Blade.
Getting that first Blood Golden rushing tier, so we're going to see potentially an early Matamune Miramana transformation coming out. If he goes fast enough, it could be really early, but Wazlin's getting poked out here. Engot doing a ton of damage. We're going to see a dash in, actually, a fear onto perhaps, but here comes XXF from the side, ice blasting onto Engot. There's going to be a 90 caliber net to disengage. Perhaps, though, has the stun ready. Going to look to turn the stun around. There's going to be a stun onto Lucian. It's going to be perhaps picking it up with the Fire Blast. Now it's going to be a fear onto perhaps from Red Hot Race, who's going to be forced to flash away. Engot going to flash forward. Flag and Drag comes in from AFAT. They give the kill to Engot, and they turn into another 2-for-none in favor of HKA.
And just Fi absolutely everywhere across the map. Saw the counter gank, wasn't right there immediately, but it actually allowed KLH to overextend just a little bit, and then just came in right there for the cleanup. Oh. Diving past the turret, gets the slow onto XXF. No follow-up, but we'll push him off of that top lane turret. And with a decent minion wave there, it's 5.5 minutes into the game, and we could see our first turret going down for Hong Kong Attitude.
This is the aggression I wanted to see from both sides. The junglers have been all over the place. We're going to see the first turret go down in a few more auto-attacks here. The 90 Piltover Peacemaker to clear out some of that wave, but a Piercing Light actually does connect and forces a little bit of that aggression off. We do see in the mid lane, though, just a little bit of harass coming out from that blue buff and tier stacking Ezreal being Pasa, as he can CS actually pretty safely with the Mystic Shots, and he's just trying to apply some Essence Flux damage to them. Up top, though, we see a little bit of a force back out there. Engot was getting poked away by Lucian, but they'll go back to base, spend their gold, which actually we haven't checked on, as he has about 1,500 in the bag, so can't buy a straight-up BF sword. So we'll see what he wants to go for with that one, but just going to be fairly calm for now.
Yeah, so very early game buys for both AD carries. Something else to notice as far as the early game's concerned, XXF had a really rough time dying there very early on, losing those double buffs, and then not really being too effective at that top gank either. Still finds himself with the only kill on his team. And when the rest of your team's falling behind, you as the guy with the kills really has to step up and get the job done. And as junglers, he's going to have a large task ahead of him. Fi has just been absolutely everywhere. Now returning back to that top lane, this is not going to go well for KLH.
He's got the Boots of Mobility as his first buy too, so there's going to be a stun onto Red Hot Rays. Here comes Jarvan from the back, perhaps is leading the charge, doing a ton of damage. There's a Flag and Drag in. It's going to be a few more auto attacks. It forces out the exhaust. You're going to get a Fear out as well. Who's going to end up picking up the kill? And perhaps it looks like Annie's going to come in from the front. Dark Winds comes out, but not before the Incinerate stun. The Dark Winds is not enough to pick up the kill. Engot is going to chase down as Flag and Drag doesn't connect.
No knockup.
Piltover Peacemaker comes in. Barrier to keep save with a headshot proc from Engot, picks up the kill, and they make it into a 2-for-0 in that top lane once again in favor of Hong Kong Attitude, as now they look to counter jungle a blue away from XXF.
Perfect call there for HKA. They knew the respawn of the blue buff because, hey, they went for that very aggressive early play. But hey, 720 right in time for that, and Fi adding insult to injury, and not only the blue buff, but top turret as well, first turret of the game, going to Hong Kong Attitude.
And they have a nice goldie at this point, 3,100 gold in their favor, just about. And still, Engot farming up a storm. He's got a decent CS lead over Lucian. We haven't talked about this bot lane for a little while. They've kind of just been going back and forth, just trading it out. We see Giant's Belt on Zac right now, being Golden's, and then Negatron Cloak for Wind as an early pickup, so just trying to mitigate some of that Zac damage. While in the mid lane, Pasa and Jaehyung just going back and forth, poking it out. Vamp Scepter Jaehyung helping him sustain up through a lot of this blue buff poke, which actually just faded. So we'll just keep an eye out for where the next gank is going to be, as XXF a little deep in the jungle there, counter jungling a wolf away, has a pink ward looking to camp out this blue buff.
But there's Engot
going to come in, and we're going to see Nuno just walk around the side. The Great Escape begins, but in the mid lane, actually, Jaehyung was forced to jump away. He's going to run into perhaps here. Just walk on by.
Wait, what?
It's going to be a stun, actually. Perhaps comes in. XXF going to be slowed down a little bit. You're going to get Ignite onto him as well. Insurnia comes in. The Piltover Beaker is dodged, but there's the Ace in the hole, and a True Shot Barrage to follow up that doesn't connect, but a kill over to Engot, making him 3-0-2, and now a dragon with the Smite and Consume being dead from the side of KLH.
Now, I'm a little bit skeptical about that XXF play, but as a Challenger Scene caster, We're going to go talk about, you know, the effectiveness that was achieved by that, and that is going to be pretty much summed up in giving HKA away a pretty free dragon. You really have a lot of trouble taking objectives against Nunu. Flash consumes Smite, really high burst true damage without a Nunu to worry about. Now it's Jae Yoon that's got some stuff to worry about.
Yeah, and looks like he's going to be jumping away. There's going to be the Cataclysm on top. He's forced to flash out while actually up top too. Pasa was trying to hold off the 2-man push coming in from KLH, and actually that turret is going to get dangerously low, as it will fall down in this wave, but a 3-man push from the side of HKA to respond in the mid lane to push down a tier 1. XXF and Jae Yoon try to hold it off, but it's still a full health turret. They'll be able to get a little bit of damage, and they're going to give up possibly the tier 1 up top as Pasa is trying to hold this on.
Yeah, Pasa actually pretty low health, won't be able to save the turret, and that will even the turret score up at 1-1. Bottom lane,
it's just a push.
That's bottom lane, kind of in a nutshell. We actually talked about this during picks and bans with KLH just going for that Zac pick to just sustain out through a lane. It's something Zac does very, very well. You can just sit him in a lane and he can just farm at his turret. You actually notice him with a pretty decent CS lead, 10 CS, just off of just pushing that minion wave back and forth. And not the most exciting lane, but it is going to be a really big source of strength for KLH these upcoming team fights. The only problem was that They should have fought one there at the Dragon, but without XXF there, there's really no point in going for it.
Yeah, and XXF actually gave over a red buff to Engad too after that kill, so he's going to harass and apply a lot of pressure. We see XXF trying to hold off the push coming in from Engad. Jae Yoon is clearing out the waves as well. Behind the turret, we do see Fiddlesticks, so he's just trying to make his way around. And they're leaving Lucian alone, though, so he's catching up in CS and actually taking a little lead over Engad, but Engad's still with those 3 kills. He's way ahead at this point, and we're seeing another blue buff go over to Pasa.
Yeah, Red Hot Ray is only level 5, so can't ult in there with a Crow Storm. That's what I was actually worried about. I was like, hey, he's waiting behind the turret. He's going to go, oh, wait, he's only
he's level 5.
So a lot of damage coming in here, a lot of long-range poke from Hong Kong Attitude. They're looking at, they had the one turret advantage, had it taken away there by that top lane push, and now, oh, fear on and got immediately the cleanse.
The cleanse comes out, the explosive shot gets applied, and he's just gonna back on out of there with the 90 caliber net. Pasa coming in right now, has a Sheen built up. We see Jarvan on the other side of the wall, potentially could look to come in. He's got an early Oracles, and what I'm seeing from these teams, they like to pick up the 10-minute Oracles. They like to get the early control. So he's doing that phenomenally on their red side of the jungle from KLH, but we're going to see a 4-man group potentially in this mid lane as we're waiting for XXF to make his way down mid. And there's a big wave up top that needs to be responded to. But Wind Down Bot doing a ton of damage to this turret. The Twin Fangs coming in, the Twin Bite, I forget what it's called, but doing a ton of damage to that turret and pushing it down to below half while the True Shot Barrage does make its way up top. We see an initiation on the XXF. He's forced to flash out. Timbers comes in, a 4-man stun. Cataclysm going to pick up a kill for HKA as now they're just going to chase this one down with a Culling, doing a ton of damage perhaps. And God is running in the front of the turret right now, flashes forward, cannot pick up the kill on Nunu, but it's going to be AFAT coming in with a double kill, taking down Wallens as the tier 1 in the mid lane goes down, and that's going to be the second turret of the game for HKA.
All right, bottom lane, yeah, that's what's been going on the entire time. And especially to note, neither one of these bottom laners running teleport. Usually when you just sit at kind of an herbivore side lane off to its own, you want to be able to at least include it in team fights at some point in the game, but it's 12 minutes in. There have been team fights that KLH really needed that presence from Golden, because right now the straight up 4v4 is so much stronger from Hong Kong Attitude that unless KLH pull Golden back into these team fights, get some strength from somewhere, HKA is just going to keep running them over.
Yeah, and we're seeing XXF trying to respond to some of these wards. He's got a Sight Stone and a Philo Stone, so potentially could look for
all
a very...
stones.
A lot of stones.
I want to see it. Tarek's really happy right now.
Gems.
People gem collecting all over the place. XXF is going to be dropping a lot more ward coverage around the map, but at this point, wards really just reveal the impending doom coming KLH's way, unless they get Golden to start to be a factor in the team. He's been sustaining up that bottom lane. He's now going to give way to Waylands, who's going to come down there and take a little bit of that pushing duty, but Fi looking to steal away a red buff of his own and work cut bottom after this for a gank. So a lot of things to watch out for in that bottom jungle for the Kuala Lumpur Hunters.
Yeah, and with the Dragon of Ascent being available to Winds, we're going to see the red buff go onto a Fi as down, but he's going to look to make his way as well as perhaps trying to decide if he wants to go down. It looks like he's going to go drop a pink ward, see that the ward is in there in the tri-brush, but Jae Yoon is going to walk in with XXF. He's got Blood Boil. He's going to jump out of there just in time to not get knocked up by the Flag and Drag. And we're seeing a lot of pink ward pressure be applied in this red side. Well, we do see attempted golems come in. We're gonna see Wallens do a little bit of damage perhaps there with the piercing light. We're gonna see a flag drag over, connects in the slow from the red buff being applied there. A fear comes out and a stun gets applied to Red Otza. The flash out. Pasa shifts over the wall, gets the mystic shot. Can he pick up the kill with the church shot brush? He does! And a blind snipe into the brush gets him the kill on Red Hots while the tier one of the bot lane does fall. That's all three outer turrets gone. HKA 10 kills ahead, a ton of gold in their favor, and now potentially a tier two gonna be pressured and possibly taken out.
And only XXF there to wave clear, and for Nunu, his only wave clear is really absolute zero, and without that spell, it's still absolute zero, so he's not really gonna be able to do too much to keep the turret alive. But finally Golden comes in for KLH and keeps his turret from going down. With a lane that just splits off even in CS, like Wind and Golden did, if you lose one turret due to the other team grouping up faster, there's almost no way to take the opposing outer turret down there in the bottom lane. KLH, they're not going to be able to go in for a huge engage, and right as I say that, Golden tries to get in there, but Pasa just arcane shifts away.
Yeah, it doesn't connect the stun, but meanwhile, the top lane, Wind has been left alone to free farm up there, as well as take his nice little CS lead over Golden at this point with a ton of time. And now Dragon just spawning. All four members of the side of HKA are on that side. They have complete ward control. They're going to head over to do it, and most likely secure this one for free. But in the mid lane, actually, Jae Yung going to jump into the end god, flash forward, knock him back with a buster shot. Absolute Zero comes in. They want to give the kill to Jae Yung. They want to try to get him rolling, and that is going to be a nice kill for them, but at the cost of a Dragon.
Oh yeah, the Tristana insect from JU knocking Engod back into the team. It's gonna be a kill, but for a dragon, for a turret. 4-1 in turrets and the two dragons coming over there. Just so much global gold. There's almost a 10,000 cold lead for Hong Kong Attitude. We're 15 minutes into the game.
That's pretty impressive, considering that we don't see that all too often. And now, Wazlin's gonna go down bot, try to farm up a little bit. JU gonna stay in the mid lane and farm. Golden's gonna go back up top and farm some more. So they're doing what they need to do from the side of KLA. They need to just keep grabbing up the farm and staying safe. They have the abilities to do so. They have a slingshot from Zac. They have the jump from Tristana, and Wallens on that Lucian can just dash away. But big ticket items are coming, and it's a Lich Bane for Pasa.
Oh my god, it
so
is
hybrid. Ezreal.
Okay, at this point, you're just like, all right, he has 6k gold, he's 3-1-2, and if you want to check out his stats, you can see that he's at 116 ability power with 167.
How many stacks on that Mana Immune right now?
All right.
Mana Immune.
We can go ahead and check that. It is sitting currently at 632 over 750,
wow.
So... hey, this is Southeast Asian League of Legends at its finest. He's going to do some long-range farming. I'm pretty sure he killed at least two creeps with that Egad, so totally worth.
Yeah, and just taking a look at the builds overall, we have the Spirit Visage and Vamp Scepter for Wind, so a lot of mitigation from a ton of AP damage coming in from the side of KLH. Well, Wind back up top, still just split pushing. Pasa's pushing in mid lane. No one looking to try to solo anybody out. They need to start grouping with KLH and try to catch what they can, because the way HKA are snowballing right now, it's just looking really dangerous as they're kind of just taunting back and forth, just little laughs, and then he gets two fists to the face as Wind does not appreciate that.
I don't think Wind is going to be too happy about that. Uh-oh. There's going to be a little stun.
XXF gets out of there, blood boils himself.
Careful.
The Oracle's Elixir for both sides. Tibbers is up, Flash is available for Annie as well. Ardent Blaze does connect, reveals Fi, and just gonna back out as it looks like a three-man push on this bot lane as they might want to try to secure this tier two, but still up top. Wind and Golden just going back and forth as this has been the story for their lane the whole entire game.
Yeah, if you want to watch a 4v4 in League of Legends, this is about as close as you come. Lichbane proc on Pasa is going to give him a lot of overall turret pushing ability, but so would a Trinity Force.
Oh, there's a stun onto XXF. There's going to be a Flash. Timbers coming in. A wall. It's a double knockup. Comes in. True Shot Bros goes across. It's going to be a kill for perhaps as they're forced to flash out the Ace of the Hole into Wallens. Picks up the kill. It's a double kill for Caitlyn now being Engod, and now potentially a inhibitor turret going to fall. A ton of damage from the Lichbane proc coming in from Ezreal. Pasa doing a lot of that. We're going to see Jae Yung trying to disengage with that buster shot, but doesn't do too much. The turret does fall, and now it looks like first inhibitor of the game going to go down at 18 minutes for the side of Yukan HKA, while up top still, Wind, just pushing. That's tier two.
Golden really, I mean, where is he? He's coming into the team fight after the rest of his team has already died, after the inhibitor's already down. If you go for an engage right now, there's what can you accomplish off that?
Gets ignited and two fists to the face just gets Golden's a kill, so something, but they still are down an inhibitor. The tier two falls. There's going to be super minions in that lane, and the strengthened minions in the other lanes, and now potentially Baron could be set up really easily for HK.
2,500 gold for wins in his pocket. He's just been doing nothing but split pushing the entire game. Permaslogue on to Fi. Chase.
He's going to be able to walk out of there.
This is the annoying thing about Nunu. Like, there's nothing he's going to be able to do against him, but honestly, what are you really accomplishing?
You're just forcing him to maybe back at a time he doesn't want to, and potentially a push could happen in this lane, so he's not going to be able to go back while Wynn did just go back to base there, and we're going to see potentially the second tier 1 of the game going to fall over as KLH make their push in. A flag and drag for Faye ends the rest of his mana, and Engod with Pasa here. Maybe looking to fight, but the tier one does fall. A ton of damage coming in onto Jae Yung from that Mystic Shot with the help of the Lich Bane. And Miramana actually was completed, and there's a needlessly large Rod. So that is AP Ezreal. And with a Miramana now, it's a ton of damage coming in. Ace in the Hole connects on the red hot rays. So right now, HK looking pretty unstoppable in this game.
All right, for everybody that was like, oh my goodness, that guy said there was going to be an AP Ezreal in this game. What are you even talking about? I'm not going to lie, I doubted it too. And I don't know, Pasa makes it happen, man. Pasa making all builds possible. So we'll have to see if he gets the damage done. Oh, Jae Yung!
Oh my god.
In range.
Mystic Shot's almost up. Yeah. I mean, two-shot barrage.
Where is it going to come? Jae Yung trying to make it back to base. Where's the snipe? Oh,
it's not going to come out. Okay. Oh, it did come out, actually. It's not going to connect. Oh, well, we do see the culling used in the mid lane as well to help clear out some of the wave from Engot and Pasa's pressure. This turret is going to fall very easily. There's a big wave of super minions in that bot lane. And still, the poke from this comp is so phenomenal coming in from HKA. And now they're just going to leave Wind to go down bot and do a ton of damage. While an initiation in the mid lane, Slingshot comes in. There's an absolute zero on knockup coming in. A Let's Bounce helps secure two kills of the Cataclysm. Crowstorm comes into the back. XXF is going to get stunned up by perhaps Exhaust gets dropped in before he can get out of there. And now Jae Yung going to come in fully healthy. And that's going to be a 2-for-1. That's something that KLH needs. But it will force HK to back off. And a really nice hold right there. A really good initiation from Golden, which is what we needed him to do.
Damage on the Nexus turrets. It was really neat to watch Wynn there. He's like, what's that? A lane without any champions in it? There's minions there too. Why don't I just walk down there? And had to kind of come initiate around from behind, so didn't really get the greatest angle on that. And only losing XXF, who's actually been very behind the entire game, it really worked out very well for KLH. But keep in mind, they're down about 10,000 gold. They've lost an inhibitor in the bottom lane. They've got damage on their Nexus turrets and just a lot of things that they're going to have to come back from. So not a miracle by any means, but at the same time, HKA looking incredibly strong.
You know what's funny? Wind is still 0-0-1. He hasn't really participated in much for this game just yet. Now with a Blade of the Rune King and a Spirit Visage, we could potentially see him look to 1v1 anybody. At this point, he's really strong. We're going to see another dragon come in from HKA. We're going to perhaps drop a pink ward and take control of this Baron pit. He's got another set of pink wards in his inventory. We're going to see the Cage's Lucky Pick helping him stack up some stuff. Another true shot brush comes to help push out this bot lane, which is already pushing in itself out pretty well with the super minions. And now I think HKA might set up for that Baron.
All right, well, Jae Yung's going to get himself a red buff over here and taking that one down. I mean, it's a little bit of a moral victory because, hey, I don't think that's really going to work out too well against, well, as a mid laner, if you want to compare both mid laners, he's going to end up against an AP Ezreal, yeah. Lich Bane, Muramana. He's got needlessly large Rod as well, so I don't know, man. That's going to be a lot of damage coming his way. And keep in mind, oh, Jae Yung takes a mix of shot over the wall. Golden!
Oh. Flag and Drag doesn't knock up, but there's going to be initiation onto Fiddlesticks. He'll get blown up instantly as now a two-man Tippers comes in.
The
Golden
culling.
Gets done. Jae Yung comes in from the side. And now Wazlins gets the culling kill on the side, as you said before, as we like to yell it in NA for really good reasons. But a nice kill with that ability. That was low damage. We're going to see them now potentially look to push in with one member dead from both sides being the support. True Shot Barrage comes
Golden.
Across. Golden gets chunked out by that one. Winds takes up the turret. Blade the Rune King to take some of the damage away from Wazlins. Absolute Zero is channeled. It's going to be the Dragon's Descent and a ton of damage from Engot to secure that kill. As now it's going to be a flash forward. Wazlins going to be slowed up by the red buff and will be able to get out of there as the inhibitor will fall. That's going to be the second inhibitor of the game going over to HKA. As the bot inhibitor is going to be spawning anytime soon, and potentially they could look to do some damage to the Nexus turrets, but they will take the safe route out, and now with the inhibitor spawning in the next few seconds in this bot lane, could be another potential split push. They could leave Wynn down there, and then they could look to pressure a Baron with four members, but KLH, after it was a pretty strong fight from them with Golden's finally joining them in that fight, he's now 2-0.
All right, so Golden's, I mean, he's not necessarily Golden just yet. It's 2-0-2, and really with no Zhonya's Hourglass, how can you really live up to your name yet?
well, maybe he'll pick one up later on the game if this goes to like maybe 40 to 50 minutes.
He's farming the way he is. He's going to be able to buy just about anything.
I wouldn't be surprised if we see him go for a little bit of AP. True Shot Barrage goes down the mid lane, helping clear out a little bit. Perhaps he's going to run into Red Hot Rays, but Pink Wards and Oracles galore for the side of HK, going to help him control this Baron Pit pretty well. And if you look in the Baron Pit, there's five Pink Wards over there already, and just coming to a huge effect. This blue buff may be the big point for another fight, unless HK just going to grab it for free.
I want to see a rap battle between Red Hot Rays and Super Hot Fire. I think that would definitely be something. We'll have to get that for halftime. Yeah, I don't know. But Red Hot Rays, he's been having an okay performance, and his 0-6-4 score doesn't really indicate that, but every time he's in there landing Furies, it always applies a lot more pressure that allows Waylands and Jae Yoong to have a little bit more of an effect on the teamfight. Now, granted, that effect hasn't been enough so far to really turn the teamfights around, and with the rest of Hong Kong Attitude on to Baron, does not look like anything's going to turn that around, and it will be the first Baron of the game. Going to Hong Kong Attitude.
At 24 minutes, a nice timing for that one. Perfect control coming out from them. They're going to see Wynn get the Baron. They're going to ping on that one like, oh, Baron just fell. Well, we're going to try to have to hold this inhibitor open in the bot lane. But a smart play coming in from HKA. They leave Wynn's down bot. They're going to put the four-man push up top and see if KLH can hold that one off. But still, they're waiting on the side. They're looking for a Crowstorm Fear and slash slingshot and Let's Bounce. We'll see if that can come into effect. But Wynn's, they need to send at least two people to respond to him right now. He's pushing out this wave phenomenally. We're seeing now Pasta come in. He's doing a ton of damage with the shift, the Essence Flux. A ton of damage, and now the True Shot Barrage comes across as a little bit too wildly. So there's the Ace of the Hole coming in. It's going to be Golden taking that one up, while now they're going to let everybody else beat into this turret. HK doing a ton of damage to it right now. Slingshot is prepped. Golden clears out the way, but a Flagon Drag comes in. Not connecting. Temporary stuns onto two people. Pops the Zac passive. The Calling comes in, but Endgod is tanking it up. Jae Yoong is going to take a ton of damage to the face. Can they pick up the kill on Zac right now is the question. Red Hot's actually picks up the kill, and perhaps it's going to be Golden's actually spawning back, going in the back line with Let's Bounce, as now HKA Wind is going to be drained and slowed out the Wazoo, as now a Flash Fear comes in from Fiddlesticks, stopping Pasta from advancing any further. They're going to ping out to the turret, stop aggressing any further. And even with the Lich Bane attacks, the Nexus turrets aren't going to fall just yet. He's going to clear out the rest of that wave. The Inhibitor is going to be the target for the rest of the members of HKA, while Pasta just kind of roams around a little bit there. We're going to see a Slingshot come in. Golden's was fully healed up, but now taking a ton of damage. It's going to be Wynn getting ignited, chased around. He's going to pop the Burnout, and now a ton of damage on the XXF. The shift in, picking up the kills. Pasta, and down goes Fiddlesticks again. Edgar picks it up.
Oh,
he's chasing this one down as a double kill for Pasta on that AP Ezreal, showing his strength. And this is looking like it's going to be game one in HKA in a dominating fashion coming out, and Jae Yoong gonna fall out there, and it's gonna be a sacrifice from Faye. And now the 1v1 potential. Can AP Ezreal beat out Lucian? It looks like he can. A ton of burst damage coming in, but the Nexus is gonna fall, and that is gonna be game one to HKA.
DJ Frost doesn't get here until tomorrow, and Mac Noon, he's gonna be coming along with him, but the do dive strategy is coming out a day early there as Hong Kong Attitude close out the game. Kuala Lumpur Hunters just starting out with a really rough set of counter jungles into XXF getting taken out early. It's just a little bit rough to deal with, so gotta give some mad props to HKA. Hong Kong Attitude really just showing how much they're kind of defying this amateur versus pro sort of distinction. We do have pro and amateur.